filmed in forever, but you guys know me already. I'm not really one for sticking around for a long time. I tend to leave YouTube for a bit and then come back, usually because I'm just too lazy to film, like I can't be bothered, or I don't really have anything to film. I don't really want to force myself to film something if I'm not feeling like filming it. So that's why I tend to leave sometimes. But if you guys have any suggestions, then feel free to leave them below. Then I'll think about if I'll do it. I'll let you know if I'll do it. But yes, today's video is going to be my March favourites. And I wasn't really wearing, towards the end of March, I wasn't really wearing a lot of makeup. So there isn't really a lot of favourites, but there are a few things that I just wanted to share. So that's why I'm doing this video today. So I'm just going to jump straight into it before I start blabbering on. So the first thing is going to be my S-Curl No Drip Hair Moisturiser. And I purchased this a while ago. I used it and I didn't really like it. But I'm really not one for wasting things. Like, I hate having things just sitting there unused. I think it's just such a waste of money. So I started using this again to spritz on my braids underneath my hair. And I love how moisturized my hair feels. So I use this as like a braid spray and it works really, really well. I just spritz it in my hand and then rub it all over and then spritz it again and then rub it into the ends of my hair. And when I take out my hair to wash it, it's just always so moisturized. I just love how convenient it is in this spray bottle because then I'm not lazy to moisturize my hair. So yes, this Body Shop Almond Body Butter, looks like that. And I have used it to death this month, as you can see. Well, last month anyway. And I'm still using it. This is one of the few ones I haven't used. I haven't used the olive oil one, the coconut one, and there's something else. I think it's Brazil nut, I don't know, I haven't used, but I've used most of them. And Body Shop were doing, I think they're still doing 50% off, but they were doing 50% off on a lot of their things. So I picked up a few body butters, like some of my favourites. And I wanted to try this one because I've not tried it before. I love how moisturising it feels because a lot of the body butters, they're not made equal. Some of them you use and they're like lotion-y and they don't do anything. They're a waste of money. Quite frankly, I think these are what, £12? Body Shop are having a laugh. I only buy these when they're doing half price because I don't think they're worth £12. Like, that's just ridiculous. But I'm more than happy to pay like £5 for them. This one leaves your skin really, really moisturized. Some of them don't. They just, meh. So this one works. So when I use it, my skin feels really soft and moisturized, and I just love how my skin feels after I've used this one. My other favorites are the, I can't remember right now, but I have a couple favorites. I think it's papaya and there's a purple one. I'm looking at it right now but I can't see the label. But yeah, those are my favorites. So I have, right now I have three favorites from the body butters. So yeah. Okay, next I have some eyeshadow products and I'm just going to pop into my MAC palette here. So if you guys don't already know, probably my all-time favorite eyeshadow is MAC's Teta Tint, and that's what that looks like. Now, I was in denial. I don't think I was in denial, but for the longest time, people were telling me if I put it in a video, people would tell me this is discontinued, and I'd go on the MAC website and it would still be there, and I was thinking, okay, what is everybody talking about? But I did some research and it is discontinued. I was so upset when I found that out because, as you can see, I've really hit pan on this and it's gone forever. I never got a chance to get a backup, sadly. So I've been kind of rationing it. But then for the first few weeks of March, I just decided to start using it again and I just remembered how much I loved it. So I was using this a lot. And the eyeshadow that I was using with it is this one, which is MAC's Espresso. Now, this one I have is a dud. I can't even swatch it for you. Well, it will barely swatch properly, as you cannot see. It's kind of a rubbish one that I got. It doesn't work properly. But what I like it for, I take a really stiff brush. Hold on, let me get the brush. So I take a really stiff brush and I use this one, which is my Inglot 80 HP brush. And it's a crease brush. And because it's really kind of densely packed, I just take the brush and really swirl it in the product. And I just use it to kind of deepen up my crease. And what I like is that it's because it's not that pigmented, because it's a rubbish one, it just darkens up the crease slightly. So I really like it for just for throwing on every day. And because this brush is so densely packed, it really gets a lot of product on the brush. So I'm just going to try and use this up somehow, because I'm just so annoyed that these are all, I think when I bought this, it was like £9. £9 for something that doesn't really work properly is annoying. So the next eyeshadow kind of product is Barry M's Dazzle Dust in number 44. Hope you can see. It's like a gold, and I got this because of Lollipop 26 when she used to make videos on YouTube. I remember her mentioning that this was a really great gold shade, and I went out and got it. Well, not straight away after I saw the video, but I got it because of her, and I barely used it. So I just dug it out for my collection, and I was like, okay, I'm going to start using this. So what I use it for is for to highlight in the inner corners of my eye. I just take a pencil brush and then pop it in, and I just love how bright my eyes look. And so this does a great job, and it's really super pigmented, so I love it for highlighting in the inner corner. So the next product are my e.l.f. Professional Powder Puffs. This is a fresh pack. I'm still going through my other pack. But I bought this to set my under eye concealer, and I love it for that because I have a bit of a problem with creasing under my eyes. I'm still kind of trying to get that perfect holy grail concealer, but I like the one I'm working with right now. But what this does, I just kind of take my MSF Natural in Dark and then kind of pack it on and pack it under my eye, and that pretty much does set my under eye concealer. I have a problem with, like, not fine lines, but I have lines just underneath my eyes, and I find that a lot of the times I do suffer from creasing there. So packing on the powder just underneath there, instead of using a brush and like sweeping it under, it really does help to help the creasing. So yeah, been loving these. Okay, so talking about under eye concealer, I've recently changed the colour that I use. If you guys have watched enough of my videos, you know that I use the MAC Select Cover Up in NC50 and the e.l.f. Tone Correcting Concealer in Spice. But recently I purchased a new shade, which is NC48. Now, the reason why I got this was because I recently purchased my first ever liquid foundation, and it's the Matchmaster. I got 7.5. However, that one is just a bit too dark for my skin, and I wanted something to lighten it up. So rather than buying a whole new bottle of foundation, I just decided to pick up a concealer to lighten up, because if you use those two together, they may actually give you a really nice finish. But the concealer that I got wasn't light enough, so it doesn't lighten up the foundation enough for me. And this, I don't know if I've mentioned, the shade is NC48. So I just decided to start using it for my under eye concealer instead, and I love using this now. So I don't have to use two different products to give me the look I want. This gives me a nice brightened under eye look, and it doesn't look too like, whoa, like reverse panda eyes. Just works really well to brighten up and give me like a refreshed feeling, because you guys have seen me without under eye concealer. That's pretty much what I wear if I'm, because I don't really wear foundation much, but I always conceal my under eyes because you guys have seen I have really quite dark under eye circles. And I'm not 100% sure if this really cancels out the darkness, because sometimes towards the end of the day I notice that it still seems kind of dark-ish, so maybe I need to get a corrector. But I love how it does give me a brightened under eye. So yeah. Okay, so next I have some lip products, and you guys know the saying, you never know what you've got until it's gone. And I never realized this until my lip balm had run out, and I'm talking about the Nivea SOS Lip Relief. It ran out sort of towards the end of February, early March, and I was dying. I needed it because there's nothing really moisturizes my lips. They're just very dry, and this just does the trick. It gets my lips moisturized, and I don't like that tingly, you know, when you have things that have menthol in it. I'm not a fan of that But I love the slip balm so much that I'm willing to put up with it. And I even bought a backup, so when I run out of this, I'm not having to go out to the shop and get another one. My backup is there somewhere and I don't have to run out. But this really works for me. And it kind of has like a, not a watery consistency, but it's not thick. It's just weird, but it just works and I love it. So for the next lip product I have, it is MAC's Crosswires and it is a cream sheen finish. That looks like that. It kind of looks coral in the tube, but it's a pink and I'm wearing it today. And the reason why I wore it for a lot of March was because I bought it sometime in the middle of last year and I've never worn it out of my house ever until March. And I thought that was just terrible. Like, I was going through my collection, I was like, okay, what have I worn recently? And I saw this and I was like, I've never worn this, why? So I started wearing it and I love it. It's a really nice wearable pink and it's the kind of pink where I don't have to think about it, I just throw it on and it's done. Because I don't like wearing lip liner, so I'm kind of shy away from lipsticks that I have to really work with. Like, I just want to put on a lipstick and leave my house. I don't want to have to reinforce my lips and do all this stuff. I only want to do what's necessary. So I've really been loving this pink. I just pop it on, smush it together, and then it's there. It's just on, and it really works for my skin tone. So I really like this pink. And I think it might be coming up a bit coral on the camera. I'm not too sure, but I have a face of the day on my blog. I'll link that below so you guys can maybe see the true colour, because I think it's coming up a lot more coral than pink. But yeah, really nice lipstick, and I showed it also in my lipstick collection video. The next product I'm pretty sure will not come as a surprise to any of you, and it is my Sleek Blush by 3 palette in Blaze, and I pretty much use it for the whole of March. There were a few times where I had to force myself to use other blushes, but why fight it? I love this so much, and this is the one that I wasn't gonna get. I was like, this is not gonna suit me at all. It's gonna be too light and it's gonna be chalky and gross and a waste of money. But it's the one, it's my favorite, it's one I've been using the most of all of them. I barely even reach for the other ones because I'm not really tempted to use them, because I've got the backup, not the backup, I've got the dupes of them, so I'm not really kind of all that interested in them. But this palette, if there was one that I had to, if I had to return all of my Blush by 3 palettes, I would keep this one because I love it so much. I just find it's just so convenient. So I always reach for this highlighter, and because the highlighter is in the palette, I'm not having to like go in there and get this highlighter and then get another blush. It's just all in one place. It's just a no-brainer, pop it on and then pop on a blush. It's just perfect. So my favorite are these two, which is Glee Pure and Croquette, and I find that the combination of these two, which I'm wearing today, I don't know if you can see, wearing these two today, I just find that they give you more of like a nice warmth and really nice warmth to your skin. These two I do use quite a lot as well, and it's more of like a glow. So yes, if you can't get this one, or no, if you can't, or if you haven't got them yet, that's what I'm trying to say, then I definitely think that you should give the Lace palette a try. So those have been my favourites for the month of March. As you can probably tell, I haven't been wearing that much makeup. I've just been popping a bit of concealer on my lids, setting it with my mineralised skin finish, and putting on some mascara, and that's about it. I'm going to try and film a bit more, because I do have some videos and some tags that I need to do, so I'll be back soon, hopefully. Okay, so I will talk to you guys next time. Bye.